Hello, welcome back to Knitting Catalog. Today I'm going to share with you how to make a baby top. I've already knitted 40 rows of my rib 11 intention line with 38 by 38 needle. So right now I'm going to continue in knitting by knitting 60 rows before I will mark it. And this is my front, guys. This is the front side. I'm going to like give it a little punch card design at the front side of it to make it different from the back, although the back and front are like the same. So but what I want to do is like give the front side a punch card design, a card design that will make it to be different from back. So let's knit on. I'm going to knit 60 rows now before I mark the both side of it. So this is so guys, I'm at 50 row right now. So I want to like put a punch card design on my front, as I said earlier. So right now I'm going to set my machine to knit punch card, and I want to knit a motif, not like all through punch card. I just want a particular area, maybe about 18 rows, to have a particular design at the chest side of the baby top. So if you have watched my punch card, how to knit punch card, you will just know how to put in place all the setting for punch card knitting. So I'm going to do all that now. Just knit like my first one row. Give my punch card information. I'm knitting. Okay. Yeah. You can see it's coming out right now. Then let me touch it. I attach the second wool. Then I open my card to big size. I want a large size of it. Then I will continue knitting still intention 9. Then it's just the design inside the punch card is just like 18 rows. Sorry about that. I see that the design is coming out. So see the end of your needle. Make sure you come out when you are doing punch card knitting. You see the end of your needle. You know, I told you when I get to 60 rows. So now I'm already in 60 rows. So I'm going to mark the both sides of my work with this yarn. Now I'm going to mark the both side that this is 60 rows of my knitting. Okay. Marking at the both side. When you get to 60 rows, no matter how the design you are putting inside your project, the design you are knitting in inside your project, make sure you mark when you get to 60 rows. Then I continue with So after the 60 row, after this 60 row, the next row after the 60 row is 40. So when I get to 40, I'm going to stop. Yeah, my punch card has ended for the motif that I choose. You can see the back. So I'm going to stop punch card knitting. Then put my card on order. Remove the second yarn. It has ended its job. Then continue knitting. Make sure you set all your carriage back to normal knitting before you continue. So I'm going to make everything now 40 row. Then 60, after 60 you mark it, then you knit up to 40 row. So I'm making it. Yes guys, I've knit up to 40 rows. So you can just see my punch card design. You see it's just a single motif as a chest design on the baby top. So this is from rib down to 60 row, then I mark it, then knit 40 rows. So the next stage is to select my stitches into 2x1 needle. I push it out, push it in, and lift it into the next needle. So I'm going to leave 2 stitches on and remove the 3rd one till the end of my project. So I'm going to do this to all the needle. This will help me to be able to fold the band I want to make for the neck region of this baby top. So it's just a way for a beginner to know when and where to fold. So that's why I'm doing this, and at the same time it's just giving a kind of lacy design at the edge of the baby sweater neck. So I'm going to pack all the needle back to working position. Then at a safe side, I'm going to push all of them to the front because I do not want to lose any stitches. I do not want to lose any stitch or stitches if I continue knitting. Now I'm going to change my tension to 8. I'm going to change it to 8. Follow me and see what I mean. I'm going to knit 6 now. Intention 8. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4. That's it. 6. You can see the hole that we have created, a kind of design, a kind of helping us to like know where we stop at 40, a kind of giving mark to 40. So I'm going to go to needle 20 here and remove, like creating a hole to remove it and place it on the second needle. That is removing the stitches and place it on the second needle. So I remove it here and place it here to create a hole. Then I'm going to go to needle 30 and remove at your left side and remove, then place it on the next needle. Then I'm going to push the empty needle back to working position. I'm going to change my tension to tension 9. You remember we are using tension 8 for this band that we are knitting now. So we are going to change to tension 9 to make this row to be a little bit bigger because of the eyelet of the button hole eyelet, so that it can be able to be like expanding when you want to fix your button. So that's why this row that I want to knit is going to be in a bigger tension to make this row a little, to make this row give room to button to be able to enter. So I'm going to knit in tension 9 right now. You can see the way it's like expand. Then I go back to my normal tension 8 and knit 6 rows. Two, three, four, five, six. So this is for the one side. So I'm going to knit another 6 again. Then create the eyelet, button eyelet again. So to 30, bring the stitch out, place it on the other needle. Then go to 20, bring it out, place it to other needle. Then I'm going to change my tension to 9 and knit 1 row. Bring the needle back to working position. Then then go back to tension 8 and complete it 6 row. So, six. It's now 24 row. We knitted 6 first and make button eyelet. Then we knit another 6 rows, then another 6, then eyelet, then another 6, making everything around here 24 rows. So I'm going to fold it right now. So we are going to pick the first stitch and hang it on the first needle, just like this. Then go to this eyelet now is what we use to fold it back, so to the needle. So go to this eyelet, and the way you remove it, where you remove it, and the eyelet back on it, the stitches on the eyelet back on it, that is, you leave 2 needle and hang it on that third needle. You leave 2 needle and hang it on the next one. Leave 2 needle, then you hang it on the next one. Leave 2 needle and hang it just like that till the end of the work. We are folding it. You see what I said, that it will enable us to know where we are going to hang our stitches back on the machine when you want to fold it. So we are folding it back. It will not make it to be like bend or somehow, it will make the folding straight back to the normal level. So you will know the right stitch to pick and the right needle to hang it on, and it will be fast enough for you to do that. So this is it. I'm going to push the needle out, all the needle, to secure my stitches. So the next one now is to cast off or bind off. So it's to cast off now. That's the end of the front side of it. So I'm going to knit exactly like this for the back, but I'm not going to like put any card design, any punch card design on the back side. It's going to be plain. So I'm going to knit my 2 row of cast off in loose tension, in tension 10, and my wool supply have to be like loose. So so that it will be easier for me and it will not be like tight when casting out. So, 2 row, intention 10 to cast off. Yes. So I'm going to cut off this and cast off. This is my front side. I'm going to start the back side right now. So guys, this is the back and front side of the baby sweater. So I'm going to fix the band area on machine to knit my sleeve. So the band area is going to overlap each other, in which the front side will go first before the back side. So I've already cast on 30 by 30 needle. I'm going to go to the mark area to the 30, and this band is going to go across to the left side of 30 needle by 3 needle. So, and I'm going to pinch it little by little at this side of it, at the band area, so that it will be easier for carriage to pass through. You see, you just pinch it a little. Then I'm going to go to this right side of 30 needle, the first 3 needle, with the front side first at the band area. So then 3 needle to the left side. So I'm using, for this band now, I'm using the center 6 needle, crossing across center 0 to right side. Then I'm going to do same here. I'm going to allow it to overlap, like pinching it little to overlap. That's the first thing to do. You can see they overlap each other. The front side is the first one I fix before this. Then I'm going to go to the mark area of my yarn, then fix it to the 30 needle, then fix this side to the 30 needle. Then I'm going to fit all the side seam of the armhole to the empty needle in between. And see, just make sure you don't take much of the side seam. Let it be a little bit light so that your carriage can pass. There is two way of knitting across. It's either you knit across with your hand knit it, or you use your carriage by using all your power to push your carriage to work. So this is it. So I'm going to loose off my mark yarn. So that's it. I've already loosed them. Then push the project back a little bit. Then I want to knit it. At times when you feel that it's heavier, your carriage cannot pass, you can knit it just like this. You can knit it. So just like this. Across the needles. Before you now make sure you now put your yarn inside your carriage for the second row to go in. So let me do that for this. You are neat. So that the carriage can pass easily because of the double band of the neck band on the machine, so that you won't need much energy and your needle won't get spoiled. So I'm knitting the first row right now. So make sure your stitches are okay, not too long, not too tight, as you are hand knitting across the needle. So now I'm getting to the end of it. So my carriage is supposed to be at this side, so let me just remove it. I'm supposed to push it to this side if I already know that I'm going to do that. So this is my carriage here. So I'm going to knit my second row right now with machine. I'm using tension 9. So, and I've already hand knit one row. So let me continue knitting. Okay. So I'm going to knit 17 rows of this sleeve with tension 9. So let me set my row count. I've already knit 2. Let me set my row count. I've already knit 2. So I'm going to use tension 9 and knit 70 rows. So you remember 30 by 30 needle, then with tension 9, 70 row without shaping. I'm not going to shape anything. I'm going to knit straight to 70 rows. So guys, this is my 70 row of sleeve, just straight down to 70 row with tension 9. So I'm going to make a rib 1-1 selection to select my needle for rib 1-1. Make sure my needle is straight. It's either you push to the front, it's safer. Like, push to the front is better than to the back. You will lose your stitches. So tension 8. That's. So this is 40 row of rib in tension 8. So I'm folding it. After folding, I will need two rows in a tension 10 and cast off. So this is the baby top with the two hand fix, so you can see it. So I'm going to sew the side seam, close it, and close the other side of the side seam. I'm going to close it, but here is the main place that is important. So I'm going to measure this area that there is buttonhole. I'm going to measure this place. That's 3 inches, you see, and I'm going to go to the other side of it and measure that 3 inches. You can see it. So to this place, from here to this place. So I'm going to like tack this place down right now. Before joining your side seam, you have to do this so that you can see space to do whatever you want to do on the neck area. So this other side is where I'm going to tack my button. So I'm going to work on the button right now and tack it. So let me use double so that my job will be easily done. So I have button here already. So I'm going to go in and make sure my needle comes out at the button side. Make sure it laps properly. The two band laps properly, and make sure your needle comes out from that place and centralize it. Yes, then I'm going to come out, then grab another space to make sure it's strong. Then I will now fix my button. So as you can see, my two button is sewn already. I have my two button on. So I'm going to come to the other side of the shoulder and clip it down, sew it down. It's supposed to be like Z sewing with sewing machine so that it won't be visible, like going like this, then cross it to this side and come back like this. So I've tacked the other side down, the second shoulder, the right side of the shoulder, I've already tacked it down. So I'm going to make use of this highlight by putting a ribbon to decorate the eyelet. So before I will go and use machine to close the sewing machine to close the side seam. So after fixing the ribbon just like this, make sure you centralize the ribbon and draw it out just like this, then cut it into two. So after cutting it into two, because you don't want it to be loosening up, like pulling up like this, so you are going to knot it like using your crochet or anything you have. Draw it back inside like this. So that it will not, the ribbon, the way you have already arranged it, will not shrink back. It will be permanent, just like this. That is, I'm going to take this edge now and to go in of this space and come out like this is it now. I'm going to draw it out. You see it? And draw it out of the circle down, so it will be permanent. You can see. So at the inside of the wrong side of the sweater, the baby top, I've already gently knot, not too big knot inside there. I'm going to light up a lighter and burn the mat gently, not so serious, so that it won't give the baby mark. So just like that, you won't even feel it. So I'm going to do at the both side, because I knot it at the both side. So I'm going to cut it, let it be a little tail, and then just like that. It's okay. So that's it. and the end here, I'm going to do the same thing with the lighter. So that's it. Then the next thing to do is to close the side seam. So close the side seam. You can see how useful the outlet that we use to fold our band is. So you can tie a bow with this, or you can leave it like this, any way you want. So I'm going to go ahead and sew the side seam, and that will be the end. So guys, this is the outcome of the baby top. As you can see, this is how it looks like after joining the side seam. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Please subscribe to my channel and like my video. Thank you for watching. Bye.